And now a more detailed look at the Pi Ace Wizard component of Ace. Remember, the Ace Wizard is what where you establish your executables and the submodules in each executable. Very often we recommend that you group various calculations into a single executable. Those groupings might be related scheduling type items, related calculations, but there's nothing that requires you to group modules and executables in any way. It's whatever's most convenient and whatever organizational behavior makes sense for you. The ACE wizard is the component that is the add-in to the development environment, Visual Basic or Visual Studio, and it is what actually writes the configuration to your module database. Now remember, the module database that you're storing your configurations does not have to be the same Pi server that you're getting your inputs from or that you're writing your outputs to, but very often it is the case. So in this section we're going to take a more detailed look at some of the functions and features of the ACE wizard. One of the functions that you use the ACE wizard for is to set the input and output parameters for your ACE calculation. And if you remember, this is what the ACE wizard dialog box looked like. Let's jump over to Visual Basic and edit our original calculation that we did in a previous exercise and bring that dialog box back up so we can see it live. And the first thing I wanted to point out and reiterate was that if you don't have one of your tags available for your input or output, you can use the create tag function from the wizard to create the tag that you need for the calculation. Now we do recommend that you do create the tags and define aliases before you create the ACE modules, but if you get if you get to this point in creating the ACE calculation and you realize you don't have one of the tags that you need, most likely it's for an output and not the input. Most likely your inputs will be there initially and you'll just need to define an output for your ACE calculation. But in any measure, you can use the configure tag button to create a tag name by simply entering a tag name and then setting the zero span and compression deviation for your tag. Notice that all of the valid point types are available for creating tags. Now the next thing I want to talk about is the filtering. And if we go back to our ACE wizard dialog box, you'll notice that the first filter we have here is called clamping. And the selections are no clamping, under range clamping, over range clamping, or both. And I'd like to describe to you what that means. Under range means that if we get a value in that is below the zero value for the tag, then we will not use the value that we record or pick up. We will use the zero value. Conversely, if you have overrange clamping, when the value is over the range of the tag, that's the zero plus the span value, do not use the value collected, but use the actual zero plus the span value as a limit. So you're setting upper and lower limits to use in your calculation. Obviously, you have the chance to use both here. Now, at this point, people sometimes say, how do I know what the zero and span are for a given tag? Well, we've conveniently given you this point attribute button. If you select a tag and then point attributes, you can scroll down and you can see what the zero and the span values are for a given tag. Now in our case, the zero value is really zero and the span value is really 100. So the zero point for the lower underrange clamping would be zero and the overrange clamping would be 100. This could be wildly different for any tag, so you have to make sure you check and not just assume it's 0 and 100. And every tag will have a 0 and a span value. So all those values can be set here. You can also reconfigure this later within the manager without having to recompile everything. There's also a bad values function. And if you look here under bad value, you can see the various selections that you can make. The default is to have no substitution. But there are some other values here that you can select. And when this is invoked is when the input tag or output tag has a value that is something from the system digital state set. These are generally considered error codes. These are things like IO timeout and shutdown or imp shut, something like that. When we pick up one of those values, we have to tell ACE what to do with the calculation. If you select no substitution, we will simply try to perform the calculation and with the values that we have. If you select typical value, we will use the typical value attribute from the tag. If we use previous value as a bad value filter, then we will use the previously used good value. You can also use the tag zero or the tag maximum value. And again, these settings can be changed later within the ACE manager at runtime.